Good afternoon, students. How are you? I hope you all are fine. Once again, I am here in front of you. I'm your English educator, and today we are going to start question answers related to Mukesh bangle industry, right? And before I start, let's see who is online. Yes, Akshat Kishore. Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, beta. How are you? Yesterday, because of some technical issue, I was not able to accept your messages. Sorry for that, Akshat. So yesterday I explained the second part of Lost Spring, that was related to Mukesh and Firozabad, right? And I already explained that chapter. So today we are going to start from question number 13, which are related to Mukesh, right? Related to Bengal industry and related to Firozabad. Okay, so let's see. Okay, describe the fact of 20,000 child workers who work in Bengal industry of Firozabad in hazardous condition. Most had a hazardous condition. Mentioned any two hazards of working in the bangle industries. Okay, so why do, or here there are two questions, means it is similar to these, that is why it is given in or. So why do the young inhabitants of Firozabad end up losing their eyesight? So let's see answer. The glass industry in Firozabad employs more than 20,000 children. Okay, we already read this in our chapter. 20,000 children, they work illegally in the glass furnaces. They work illegally in glass furnaces with high temperatures. Okay, they work in dingy cells. Dingy, that means dark and dim room, right? They work in dingy cells without air and light. They often sit with their parents in dark hutments. They are working with their parents in dark hutments. They weld pieces of colored glass into circle of bangles, right? Their eyes are more adjusted to the dark than to the light outside. Okay, student, this is why they often end up losing their eyesight before they become adult. This is really very easy question. I already explained this chapter. Next, who was Mukesh and what was his dream in life? What did he do to achieve it? Otherwise, see, three questions are there in a or form, right? So what was Mukesh's dream? In your opinion, did he achieve his dream? Then who is Mukesh and what is his dream? So let's see. If we talk about Mukesh belongs to Firozabad. He also have the business of glass industry, means having a business of making bangles, right? He was facing lots of problem related to money, related to this business. He is not earning lots of money from this business. That is why he decided to learn how to drive a car, and he wanted to open a garage. He wanted to become a mechanical, means wanted to do some work related to mechanic field, right? Now see, young Mukesh belonged to a family of bangle makers in Firozabad. He also belongs to Firozabad. He didn't like the profession of bangle making because he was facing lots of problem related to this business, right? He was not able to earn lots of money from this business. He entertained new dreams. He wanted to be his own roaster, right? He wanted to be his own master. Okay, this is the problem of the book. Okay, so he wanted his own master. He wanted to become a motor mechanic. What? He wanted to become a motor mechanic. He would go to a garage and learn his art. He would go to a garage and learn his art, and he seemed to be determined to achieve his modest aim. Okay, nice answer given for this question. And most of the time, student, if you understand this chapter, so that is really very easy for you to write this chapter in your own words. Okay, so Charumita Sharma is there. Good afternoon, Charumita. How are you, beta? Ma'am, question number 13 is the start of second part of the chapter, question and answer. Yes, from question number 13, we are talking about the Mukesh and Ferozabad and glass industry. Means these all questions started from question number 13 related to part 2 of the Lost Spring Akshat. Okay, let's see 15 number. Describe the kinds of bangles made in Ferozabad. All color means they are making pink, blue, green, purple, all colors make bangles making in Ferozabad, right? So Ferozabad is famous for bangles. This thing we knew very well, that Ferozabad is famous for its bangles. The town produces all the bangles for women. We knew this thing, that bangles, actually bangles is related to women, and bangles for the women of India. Bangles of all sizes and colors are made here. Okay, one may have sunny gold, paddy green. There is a choice between royal blue, pink or purple. Every color out of the 7 colors of the rainbow is available here, right? Nice. Then little has moved with time in Ferozabad, says Annie's Jung. Why does she say so? The narrator is making a statement of fact. Actually, little has moved with the tune is Ferozabad. See, tune is, I think, a wrong word over here. The old bangle making industry goes on as usual. Okay, so goes on the exploitation, we can see, goes on as usual, that means goes on exploitation, okay, of bangle makers with it. More than 20,000 young children working illegally in these industries and glass furnaces with high temperature, right? They are working illegally, student. Right, that is out of law. The exploitation of the money lenders, the middleman and the policeman continues unabated. Right, now see next. So why does the author say that the bangle makers are caught in a vicious way? Why does the author say that bangle makers are caught in a vicious web? Why she says so? Because she saw the miserable condition faced by this Mukesh family. And we are not talking about Mukesh only. The person who belongs to this industry, this business, all they are facing the same problem, right? So when narrator saw the miserable condition of Mukesh, she came to know that how much problem they are facing, right? So why does author say that bangle makers are caught in a vicious web? Let's see answer. The bangle makers of Ferozabad have lost all initiative and the ability to dream as they are caught in the web of poverty. Right, and they are also caught in the vicious circle of moneylender. They are also caught in the vicious circle of money lenders and the middleman, the keepers of law and the bureaucrats and the politician, and they can't stand on their feet and organize themselves into a cooperative, right? They fear to be dragged to jail if they fight for their right, right? So that is why they are tolerating all these things. They can't take any action against this. They all are facing this kind of problem, okay? So Okay, next question. Now let's see which forces conspire to keep the workers in the bangle industry at Firozabad poverty. Okay, so the workers in the bangle industry in Firozabad have fallen into the vicious circle. I already told you this vicious circle and middleman and the money lenders, right, in previous question. Okay, they don't allow them to organize themselves into cooperative. The police always acts with the middleman to haul up the workers, right? They are beaten and dragged to jail. Poverty, apathy, greed, injustice conspire to make them miserable. Okay, now see next. What are the problem faced by the bangle makers? Which kind of problem faced by bangle makers? The bangle makers working in the glass industry of Firozabad. They all are working in the glass industries of Firozabad. Face many problems, right? First of all, they have to work in subhuman conditions. Right? First of all, they have to work in subhuman conditions. They work in dingy cells or in the glass furnaces. Right? They work in dingy cells, that means dim dark room, or in the glass furnaces with high temperatures. Okay? They become blind quite often because of these oil lamps and all these things with the high temperature. Okay? And then they have fallen in the web of poverty and exploitation. Money lender, middleman and even policemen exploit them. How much people include over here? Money lender, middleman and policemen, even politicians also exploit them. Okay, next. Why could the bangle makers not organize themselves into a cooperative? Why could the bangle makers not organize themselves into cooperative? So money bangle makers of Firozabad can't ever attain economic independence. The vicious circle of money lenders, middlemen, politicians and police frustrate their attempts. They fear to be holed up by the police, okay, beaten and dragged to jail for doing something illegal. They beaten or dragged to jail for doing something illegal. So they have lost all initiative to organize themselves into a cooperative. Okay, then next, listening to them, I see two distinct worlds. Listening to them, I see two distinct worlds in the context of Mukesh, the bangle maker's son, which two world is Anees Jung referring to. Okay, so Anees Jung refers to the two contrasting worlds. Anees Jung referring to the two contrasting worlds, she speaks of poor and ignorant bangle makers. She speaks to poor and ignorant bangle makers and the world of sahukars, middlemen, policemen, politicians. They exploit the poor bangle makers. The two worlds are of the exploits and the exploited. Mukesh, the bangle maker's son, is caught between these contrasting worlds. Right, that is why he want to escape from this thing. That is why he decided to learn how to drive a car. Okay, next, justify the title of the lesson Lost Spring. Very important question, student. Lost Spring of Anees Jung describes two stones of a stolen childhood. Okay. And here in a first part we talked about Saheb-e-Alam and in a second we talked about Mukesh. Okay, so millions of children in India waste their childhood in rag picking or hazardous industries. Okay, means most of the children in India waste their childhood in rag picking or hazardous industry. Okay, and then but unfortunate children like Saheb and Mukesh waste this spring either in garbage or in the blast furnaces. Okay, in this question both boys are explaining, we are explaining both boys, Saheb Alam and Mukesh also, right? Now their best part of the life is lost the demands of survival. Okay, hence the title is quite apt and logical. Okay, understand this thing. Then next short answers related to this short answer related to part 1. We already explained these answers, student. Here somebody new, B2K. Okay, hello. So student, up to here we completed our chapter, which is Lost Spring, and we already completed about the first part and second part, both part completed, and question answers related to this chapter also completed. I hope you understand this chapter very well, and from tomorrow we are going to start our new chapter, and be ready for that. And what you have to do, you just read it once and read all question answers once, student. Okay, so up to here we are going to stop our video. Till we will start new chapter tomorrow. Till then, bye bye students.